I mean, and I don't know how many of you pop your fingers and crack your fingers and stuff like that, you know, and you hear that snapping sound. Well, what causes that snapping sound is basically this. You know, where you have any joint, you know, like say in your finger, right in between here, you have a fluid. And it's a lubricant, okay? Well, when we snap our fingers or pop our fingers, what the torque and the change of position that we're doing when we do that, what we're doing is we're taking this fluid and we're rapidly popping it out where it usually is, between the two knuckles or whatever, and when it rapidly pops out, that's what gives us the sound that we hear. And then, of course, it goes back in. And, of course, we've always heard all our lives, you know, stop that, you know. Mom, Dad, slap you in the hand, stop that, you're going to hurt yourselves. And they were right, because the more this is meant to be a lubricating fluid, the more that we're snapping it out and stuff like that, the more that we're using it up. And so, yeah, they were right. We really shouldn't be popping our fingers and snapping them and stuff like that. Okay, arthritis, guidelines, assist with exercise, range of motion. You know, if you do have somebody really bad with arthritis, really, really bad, and say you're going to walk, because see, one of the programs you may have is called walk and dine, where you walk them from their room to the dining room, and you know they're going to hurt in their knees or hurt in their hips when they're going to walk. Well, you always can ask the medication nurse if they could give them something for pain, maybe 30 minutes or so before you walk them, so that way the walk isn't so painful for them. Now, something else, anytime you have and this isn't a test, this is just extra, anytime there's a weather change, you know, the barometric pressure will cause swelling of soft tissue, and it will cause more compression on nerves. So always expect your people with arthritis to hurt more when the weather's starting to change.
I have a question. Sorry. With the popping, is it the same with your back? Because chiropractor popped the back.
Right. That is a good question, because they're doing it the right way. When we're popping our fingers, we're doing it the wrong way. So when they're popping the back or popping this, and of course it's not near as much. You know, I may pop my fingers 20 times a day. Of course that, when they're doing your back, is like once what? A week sometimes or once a month. But because they're doing it the correct way, they are not making this fluid movement. So it's not causing the sustained damage like when I'm doing this. So with the arthritis, a lot of times cold will hurt them more, so they may need to be warmer. A lot of people like will get the arthritis in their fingers and they'll be crippled, and they simply, where did my pen go? They can't hold a pen. So basically, what'll happen is they'll have, you know, they can't, just for a spoon, they simply can't hold it because they're all crippled up. Well, one of the adaptive devices is a band that can fit around the palm like this, and the spoon can fit right in there because their wrist is okay, their elbow's okay, their shoulder's okay, it's just their fingers. So if the spoon kind of fits in there and they're all crippled up, and it fits in there, they can still feed themselves. So, you know, that would definitely help self-esteem. It would help their feeling of self-worth. I mean, that at least they haven't lost all that, that they still can do something for themselves. Bursitis, of course, is a condition with the burst of the tiny sacs of fluid found near joints becomes inflamed. This is where people will talk about more about, you know, the knuckles really hurt real bad. Amputation, of course, is that surgical removal of the hand, foot, leg, or arm. And like I said, when you get people back, you literally have to watch that wrap for the first several days. And if you see any blood on there, let them know. When the wrap comes off and they start using their artificial leg, we gotta look at the stump. We gotta look at the stump and make sure, because it can get a pressure sore on it, that they don't have a sore there. So looking at their stump and the diabetic's foot are two very, very important things that we basically need to do. Phantom sensation and phantom limb pain, which I talked about. Fractures, of course, is a broken bone. If you ever come across a resident who's fallen and they got their legs out in front of them,